गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर।
थैंक यू। माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर एस के नायक, आई एम डीलिंग्स विद द सब्जेक्ट दैट इज ओरेकल एंड मल्टीमीडिया, लैब ऑन ओरेकल एंड मल्टीमीडिया, व्हिच इज इन योर सेमिस्टर 3, बीसीए सेमिस्टर 3, एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ योर सिलेबस दैट इज योर लैब ऑन ओरेकल एंड मल्टीमीडिया व्हिच आई एम टेकिंग, राइट? This will be the first session, and if you have any doubts also, you can interrupt me and you can ask the questions, and if you have any doubts further also, so you can join in the discussion forum which is provided by the Bharati Vidyapeeth University, right? I think it is clear to you. Now, as we have the syllabus is Oracle and Multimedia, so I'll start first Oracle. What is Oracle? Why we use Oracle, and what about the Oracle, and how we can implement little bit? We can use the practical oriented in this particular limited sessions. So I will explain each and everything. If you have any doubts in between, you can ask. But you have to see that the things which can be solved at your level, you can solve easily at your level. So you can skip. Otherwise, I'll tell everything details about Oracle, how to use the Oracle and Multimedia simultaneously. So if any doubts, you are free to ask the questions, right? So I'll start now. Before starting the practical part, just I'll let you know about why we are using Oracle. What is Oracle? So in brief, in a particular limited time, I will explain. Oracle is a tool, software, which is developed by different companies, right? So normally what happens when we have a different kinds of concepts like a database management system, relational database management system, this concept can be incorporated through different software, right? So we can use the concept, we can use different kinds of practical oriented task, right, which is related to the database management system or a DBMS, relational database management system. You might have come across these concepts in your semester, earlier semester, right? So I think no need of explaining what is difference between these two. So now when we are going for implementing the relational database concepts, that time we have to see what are the different apps, different applications, different softwares are available for implementing the concepts of a relational database management system. I think, Diksha, you can understand what I am expressing. Yes? So if you have any doubts, you can ask the questions. Now, the first of all, what about the things we have studied in the database as well as in a relational database, right? So this concept can be implemented through software like Oracle softwares. So Oracle company is there. Oracle has developed itself one software that is Oracle, and we have different kinds of versions like Oracle 9i, Oracle 8i, Oracle 10g, 11i. These are the versions of software. Similarly, we have a Microsoft company. They have developed the concepts of relational database through some software that we have a Microsoft SQL Server. You might have heard this word, Microsoft SQL Server. The software they use for database or to implement the concepts of database or relational database. So we use different kinds of. Similarly, IBM company, IBM DB2. DB2 is used by IBM, or it is developed by IBM company. They have developed that software, DB2. So different companies, different software companies, they have provided different kinds of tools for implementing the concepts of relational database management system. Very interestingly, we have in our Bharati Vidyapeeth, we are implementing the Oracle software, genuine softwares we have. So we use at our institute level for regular students. I'll show you how to use different kinds of Oracle products, right? So now normally it is authorized, or it is actually, if you'll see the ranks of database softwares, so somewhere you will find that of most companies, that is Oracle companies, have provided so many Oracle apps for different purposes. So it may have a different kinds of analysis. Sometimes we can go for normal database concepts. Normally we can go for different kinds of data analytical things, and we can go for data mining, we can go for data sciences, or we have different kind of analysis, data analysis. Normally, if you are going for OLTP, you might have known this abbreviated word, OLTP, Online Transaction Processing System, OLTPS we call it. And we have OLAP, Online Analytical Server we have. So we are not going for OLAP sites, we are going for OLTP sites. We can make day-to-day transaction, we can make different types of Oracle queries, and we can execute it, and simultaneously, what about the actions, or you are performing the different types of actions, it can be performed in the backend that is in the database. Now, in Oracle, what sorts of things we can cover? As per your syllabus, now we have total practical things we can divide into the similar way I can explain. One is structured query language SQL syntax. One is, so in SQL syntax, we'll have different types of syntaxes. Now we can have different types of sub-languages. You might have come across in database management system in RDBMS. What are the sub-languages we have in database? We call it sub-languages, right? Rather language, right? Why? That is the theoretical part. If you have doubts, you can ask me later if you know, eager to know the what is, why I'm telling this is sub-languages, right? So now why we call it languages or sub-languages, right? So different types of languages we have, sub-languages we have, we can implement through different queries, that is SQL queries, structured query languages we can use. What are these? We have a data retrieval statement. Normally, we have to retrieve the data from the database. The second thing, that is DML statement, data manipulation statement. We have different kinds of sub-languages, data manipulations, right? The third one is we can use DDL statement. What is the DDL statement? Data definition. We can define the database. We can define the different types of relations. We can define different kinds of tables, okay? Views, different types of objects we can define. What are the different database objects you might have covered in your theoretical part? I will explain also. Next, you will have a TCL statement, or TCL language we call it, transaction control language. We have a different kinds of transaction control languages we can use in our SQL. Now, next is DCL, data control language. What is data controller? How to control the data? How to control the users? How to control the database? That's regarding your DCL. So what is the top? Data retrieval statement. We have to retrieve. Through select statement, we can use data retrieval operations. The second one is DML statement. We have insert, update, delete, merge. So these are the statements for DML statement. We call it data manipulation statement. And the next one is we have DDL statement. Data definition languages, that is called create, alter, truncate, rename, drop. These are the statements under your DDL statement. We have TCL statement, transaction control languages. So we have to control the transactions, that we have a save point, then we have a commit. Then next one we have rollback. So rollback, commit, set point. These are the three statements under TCL statement, transaction control language. Next, we'll have data control. So we have to control the data. We have to control the user. We have to control the database. So we call it DCL, data control languages. In data control languages, you will have a grant, revoke. We have to grant the privileges. We have to revoke the privileges. We can take out the privileges if you have assigned, right? So these are the statements we can have in our DCL statements. So these are the overall tasks we have to complete in this lab session. So you can see one by one, I'll show you, I'll demonstrate you different kinds of syntax. I have installed one software for Oracle product, that is one is 10G software I have installed. We have Oracle 9i, we have 10G, we have 11i. These are the different kinds of softwares related to the database for different purposes. Normally, what happens in corporate life, we use 11G or 11I or 10G we use. But as a learner or some extent, if you'll see, normally you have to see a standard versions of a database, that is Oracle 9i you will have. But it is difficult to installation to make proper work on it. It is too difficult. So you need some expertizations guide, a guide or expertizations help you need. So to self-learning, it is easy to install 10G. So you can install the 10G. I'll share the screen. I'll show you the 10G softwares. So just you will put or just you will install this by clicking. Okay, it will show you different types of wizard. So through wizards, you can install properly. And he will ask later on at the end of your installation, the software asks you to give a password, username and password that you have to set as a system password, that is admin password, top admin password. So now I am going to share my screen. Just see it is visible. If it is not visible, just prompt me that it's not visible, right? So I'm just sharing this screen directly. I can show you the screen sharing options. Yes, I think it will be visible for you. I think it is clear. Just I will minimize. Now, I have a different queries over here. I'll show you. I have different queries here. I have mentioned. I have three files you can see, right? So I'll go for first one, the simple query, right? This is query. Now, what happens? Because if you use different types of queries right here, you need some database objects to create. Now, these are the syntax we have. Directly, we can execute. I think, Disha, is it visible to you? Now, I'll move to directly to the 10G software, okay? Now, you can see in the desktop, you can see here, I think this is Oracle 10G I have installed. And when you will install the Oracle 10G, after successful installations of 10G, okay, you can click, there is two way. Now I can show you. Now you can click in the start button. See here, I can show you. Here you can see the database stop and start, right? So you can click here, run SQL command. This is a command prompt. You will have two prompts here. One is SQL command prompt. Another one is browser based. Through Internet Explorer also you can use. Now just I am waiting for responses. See here, if your software has been installed successfully, so after clicking on this, you will get this message. What is this message? SQL Star Plus release 10.2, this is 10G, right? That's why it is versions 10.2.0.10. This is you can have, and you will have a SQL prompt on it. If it is not properly installed, you cannot run the this prompt, right? Now, here the one way you can use command prompt, and you can create, you can do anything in this particular interface. This is called command line or command prompt, SQL command prompt. Now, I'll exit it, and I'll go for second one. I think the process you might have observed. Now I'll write here exit, and I have to stop this because I have to move for second interface, that is GUI based, or we call it browser based. Now in browser, I'll show you, this is your like Internet Explorer. So you can type, I can click here, I'll show you. You can type 127.0.0.1, you can see this. It is not connected now, I'll connect it. So now, this particular things you can note down if you want browser based, right? You see, it is coming. Now, this particular IP address, it is very important. It is there in the installations file also. I'll show you, because in our syllabus we are not covering the DBA track, right? So this installation process we mainly call the DBA track site, right? So if you want, really need, you can suggest to the university. I can also ready to take this particular part, right? So now, as per your syllabus is concerned, that is your developer track. So I can log in through this particular browser. Now I can click login here. This is important. You have to type, then you have to enter. So after getting this site, right, you can put here system, because at the beginning installation process, you might have come across the wizard that is set your password for system, right? So I am entering my password here, what I have given at the time of installation. So now I am putting my password here and I am giving enter button. So it takes times because it is directly in the browser. Now you will have four different kinds of graphical interface here. This is for administration. You can click here if you want to see storage, memory, database users, monitor, about data. We are not going for this because this is about DBA track. I'm not going for, as per the instructions by the university, it is developer track. So we can move. I'm not going for browse the objects also. This is also some kind of database administrator's job. You can have, these are the objects you have, right? So back, you can go for this one, SQL, because you need the prompt where you can fire or execute different types of query. Click on this. Now you will have this screen. This is called the graphical user interface for database. So now here, automatic commit display, this is tick. If you are executing any queries which has to be permanently reflect on the database, you can click here, auto commit, right? Automatically it is saved. Otherwise you can tick out from this. So now if it is tick, automatically it is saves. If it is untick, that means you have to manually, you have to save, that is comment statement you have to file. Next, display is 10. So 10 items or 10 records will display at a time. If you want to enhance, you can put 50. So you can set here. Now here we can do our task. What are the different types of statement, as I told, so we'll have. So first is data retrieval statement. I am writing in short, data retrieval statement, right? So what is the data retrieval statement? We can use select statement, S-E-L-E-C-T. This is a keyword you have to use for data retrieval. The second one, you can use DML statement, DML. So DML stands for, I think you might have known, data manipulation language. So in data manipulation language, we can use insert. I'll write insert because time taking. Insert, update, delete, and merge, M-E-R-G-E, merge. So now, again, you will have DDL statement. DDL statement, data definition language. So we can create table or alter table or drop table or truncate table or rename table, or you can have create, alter, delete, create, alter, drop, truncate, rename. Okay, so these are the statements on the, yes. Any doubts?
Comment, sir.
Yes, anything. Just I'm giving dot, dot, dot. These are the main syntax we have, right?
Yes,
sir. Next, we have DDL, DML, DDL, then TCL statement. Very good. So now, TCL statement will have transaction control language. What are these? Now, as I told in the interface, you have an auto commit. So we can have a commit, a rollback, then you have a set point, SAV set point. Why I'm writing? Because this is very rarely students uses this statement, right? So commit, rollback, set point. So can I write this rollback? Rollback. Because I have to cover so many things. I have a limited lectures, right? So that's why I'm just making that like everywhere it would. So rollback, this is commit. COMMIT. Here, this is also written commit, auto commit. So this is under TCL. Then we will have a DCL. So in DCL, we will have what sorts of statement? That is grant, GRANT, or revoke, REVOKE. So we can grant privileges, we can revoke the privileges, right? So these are the main statement we use. And we have other things also, which we have to cover, like we can have a different kinds of database manipulations. Later on, we'll see if time permits, right? So these are the things I'll let you know one by one, okay? So I'll show you one query related to all those query you have to cover at your own, because I have to complete it. Because if this statement will cover, then you can directly appear the OCA exam, Oracle Certified Associates. That is under proprietary center in the different metropolitan cities. They have a proprietary center for certification, Oracle certification. So OCA for Oracle Certified Associates. So you will have two modules, that is SQL and PLSQL. So you can cover easily. So this part will be covered, one part will be covered if you will complete these things. So it will be very important if you have ideas to do some career on Oracle, that is the chance to you. And you have to cover. Just I will let you know all types of statements under this. Just you have to cover. Okay. So now today we'll discuss about select statement, different types of select statement. Before select statement, you should have some objects here. So what is database objects? It's very important while we are using. So now DB objects. What are the different objects we have? You might have come across in theoretical part. What are the database objects? Now, can you suggest different types of database objects instantly? Now, one is table, right? One is view. Third one is, we can use database object views, then sequence, SEQUENCE. We can create sequence. You can create index, INDEX. We can create different types of procedures also, triggers also. So procedure, right? Triggers, synonyms, short, I have written short. So now, then triggers, then package, PSC. Create also package. So these are the end dot, 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 you will have a number of other things also we have, okay? So now these are the important part, database objects we can create, then we can use different types of select statement. Now, to see what are the different types of database objects you have, one query we have, select, I can finalize, star from tab. I have given one query, right? Is it visible? Or shall I make it more larger one?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Visible, very good. So now I have written all small letter, but the syntax is like you have to always practice like this. SELECT star, this is next from. This is the way of writing a good programmer always follow the syntax, how to write properly, right? So we can use like this. Tab. Now here I am using select capital letter because it is a keyword, from also keyword, but this word, it is related to your tab. You can use capital letter or you can use small letter, but if you follow the format, actually generic format, it will be easy to find out or to debug it properly. So whenever you will have any kinds of error, and when you will have a more number of statements in a particular program, so it will be easy to find out, fetch out immediately the error, right? That's why it must be. So now I can execute it, run it. Here you can see these are the tables you have. I think you might have seen this. You can see, you can visualize this. All these tables, views, these are called database objects. We have set 50 rows. If I set 800, you might have seen rest of the all the tables. See here, 100. It is more is there. More than 100 rows available. If I'll put, see here. How can see? I can make it 200. I can see here. So how many tables and objects we have? Again, you have more than this. So 163 rows returns. So what happens here? We have a different kinds of database objects we have. Here you have a tables, here you have a synonym, as I told, the synonym, duplicate name of a table, right? So table, then view, okay? So different kinds of view for database. We have a different kinds of tables here, log tables we have, different kinds of objects you have. We call it database objects, right? So now this is the simple query which helps to retrieve how many tables or how many objects are there in the database. Objects, you should tell objects. And when you are talking about only table, this is one type of object, database objects, right? So now we can use, these are the DBA sections, okay? We cannot use, these are the database file, program files. We cannot use this. What are the user files we can use? You can modify, you can do anything, right? So now here I can access any table which is already I have created. So I can put here table name. Now suppose I want to access all the records of a particular table. So I can fire one query, select star from table name. What is the table? For example, I have a client underscore master table I have created. Now when we'll move to how to create the table, I will show you, right? So this is for data retrieval, right? See here, these are the number of records you can see here. Now here, one part we can add here, conditions. Now this is select statement, this is from clause, these are the clauses we call. In English grammar, you might have seen or you might have known that what is clause, right? So now clauses means a part of your whole statement, right? Clause. So now select statement helps to take all the column name. From clause takes the, I can write here. You can mention the column name. Column name, right? Here you can mention table name. From which table, right? So after mentioning this, okay, so you can give a condition here that we call where clause. Where clause. So now you check here, I will put one. You can see what is the syntax I have written to display all the records, because star is there, asterisk we can give. If you want to only display few records, suppose I want to display only client number and a city. So you can put here client underscore number comma city. Now this is from table name. I can mention here table name from client underscore master. This is table name. And I can put here the condition. But what can be done here? We can put a condition to restrict the whole display. Now you can see here, 6 records are displayed. Total records are displayed. I don't want to display all the records because I have to make projection. So we have one operations like selection and projections in your relational algebra. I am not going details about that. You might have studied in theoretical part. So now when we are restricting column display and when we are restricting the record display, we call it projection, not selection operations. That is called projection operation. Now, if you want to display complete record wise, this is record wise complete, right? All records have been displayed here. So this is called selection operation. Now, what I'm going to execute the query, it is show you the projection. How you can see here. Now I can put here where city, C-I-T-Y, city equal to, I can put here double quotation mark, Bombay, B-O-M-B-A-Y. Check it. Run it. Now somewhere you will find identifier is not city equal to Bombay. I think this will be within the single quotation mark. Just a minute. y, right? Yes. Clear? So when we are giving, it is not double quotation, because double quotation is more than one word. So when you will have a multiple strings, you can give that. So you can see here, this is a projection, four rows, but only two columns we have. This is how we can find out the different kinds of informations related to a particular table. So you can execute and type. Now next I'll show you, we can do some arithmetical calculation in select statement. How? You can see here, arithmetical calculation. So when we are going for calculating arithmetical calculations, so by default we use different kind of tables, or we can use by default dual table. It's a temporary temp table which can be used for normal arithmetical calculations. Now I'll show you. If you know, you can prompt, I can skip, and I'll have a larger or difficult complex statements also. So now here I can put here select. Suppose I want to calculate 12 into. Now 12 is months, right? So 12 into. Now my salary is, for example, 10,000, and it must be as a salary. So this way we can display from. I'm just calculating. I'm not accessing any tables column. I'm just putting in arithmetical calculations over here. So I can use dual table, D-U-A-L. So it's a dummy table which can be used for this type of calculations. Now we have a different kinds of statements. I can show you here for dummy table. Just I will explain, you can execute at your end. I'm not going for details because it's simple, you can use, right? So now see here, in your syllabus you might have seen this. Okay, ABC functions, it returns the absolute value from your whatever the number you are giving. You see here, I'll copy this and I'll put in this particular interface directly. So I'm using here dual table. I'm taking a value which is a negative floating value, which can be converted into absolute value. That is ABS. ABS means for absolute value. So run it, you will have a 243.5. So negative becomes your positive value, right? Similarly, we have different kinds of functions, like mode functions we have, you can take. I'm going for random. If you have doubt, you can interrupt me and you can ask me. So now this is mode functions. Mode functions returns remainder. So by dividing this 18 divided by 4, what would be the remainder part? It will display. See here, run it. So remainder is 2. This is not the result, this is the remainder part. So 18 divided by 4, that means 4 fours are 16, and 18 minus 16, remainder is 2. So that remainder you can put here, right? So now similarly, you can have, these are all syntax based on dual table, or you can use also normal database objects also. I will show you. Now this is another power functions we can use here. This functions also, this is 4 raised to 2 for square, right? So you can have this 16. So first part will be the base value, and the second part will be the index value, the power value, right? So you will have 16. Just I will show you. If any doubts, you can ask without any hesitation. And students, this is for your Oracle, okay? And I'm doing this practical for you. At least you can understand, you can execute, you can do at your end. That's why I'm doing this part, Oracle Lab, right? I'm not giving any theory here. So now, here you can see round functions. Normally, because sometimes you will have a different variations of round, right? If you are taking a value with respect to, this is two parameters we have in functions. Round functions takes two values. Here one, the original value, which has to be rounded, and which place, up to which place it must be rounded. That's the place value you can give. So now in this particular format, it takes one value which has to be rounded, second value which place, up to which place you make it round, right? So that is the zero. So zero means decimal part. See here, 345. Did you get this? 345, because we are rounding till decimal part. Zero means till this. That means total integer part you will have complete. And decimal part, it will be rounded. So 156, it is, if you'll see the three digits number, so uppermost number you will have 999, or if you'll see 1000, from the 100 to 1000, right? So 500 is the middle value. So more than 500 becomes, it can be increased here. Now if you'll consider this one also, that will be also enough. One digit, then it is till 10. Two digit till 100. Three digit till 1000. Four digit till 10,000, like this. So you have to find out, suppose one digit you are rounding. See here, I am taking one digit here. What is the value of this? Now it becomes, when you are rounding 0.1, next you have to see what is the value. 5, 6. That means more than it is 5 or 56. That means we have to go for upper part of this rounding value. We have two values, a lower part and upper part. If it is 0.5 less than, then you will have lower part, and 0.5 more than, that is 50%. If it is more than 50%, then you will go for upper part. If it is less than 50, then lower part, right? So now what exactly the mean is, suppose if you are considering 10 rupees, 10 rupees, that means two digit you are taking. Suppose I'll say 20 rupees or 20 paisa, that will be rounded because no one can take 20 paisa. But it is, if it is more than 50 paisa, then they will take 1 rupee from you. Because more than 50 paisa becomes rounded to the upper part, that is 1 rupee, 100 paisa, right? So similarly, this fashion, you can put any value and you can check it. You can observe it. That's the things you have. Now I'll show you in the here one interesting part, the third one. See here, 345. I have given minus 1. Minus 1 means, what is this? That means it takes a integer value, one integer value, not this side. So after decimal, these are positive value. Before decimal, that is integer part, you will take minus value. So when you are completing this 45, right, it is not more than 50. So it will be strict to 50, not 100, right? Now, what happens here, we can see, we are going for, see here, minus 1, we are taking this 5, this digit, I'm highlighting. Now, we have to check it 4. Now, 4 must be changed. It must be rounded. So it may be 4 or it may be 5. Depends on this value, the position's value. Similarly, you can see here, the position value 1, that means depends on the value, it must be rounded, right? So now here we are talking about 45, 40, 45, that means exactly 45.0, and it is near to 50, round it. Now sometimes the student may ask, if exactly 50, suppose within 10, we have a 5 rupees, it must be rounded to 10 or it must be rounded to 1 or 0. That's the doubt. So as per your convenient, you put it. Because normally system takes, if you have a 0.5 exactly, it takes the next part, upper part. System takes, right? So as per your requirements, you can put here the round value, right? Why we need this round value? Sometimes we have to give a absolute value, concrete value to the customer. Suppose I want to pay. If you might have seen some articles or some items, they normally pasted the price tag like 99.95 paisa. So how can you give 95 paisa? We will give 1 rupee. So complete 100 rupees you can give. So this way, sometimes we need a rounded value, right? So to make some transaction, to make a visible, proper visible, or sometimes for calculations purposes also, we need a rounded value, right? Like if I'll ask you what is your exactly age, So you cannot say number of days, number of months, number of years. You just say only year. Okay, I am 25 years, I am 30 years, I am 15 years, whatever may be. But if you say fraction of these things, it will be very difficult to fetch or difficult to grasp it, right? So sometimes we need rounding the value, right? I think you're clear. So rounding value, then you will have a sign. Different signs, you can have a sign value. So if it is minus 12, you can see here, you can have the different types of value, sign value, what with the sign you can show you, okay? So depends on the condition. If number is greater than 0, return 1, that is positive value. If number is equal to exactly 0, it returns 0. If less than this, then negative value. Now come to this, I'll execute it, Control V, run it. Now see here, minus 12, why it is coming minus 1? Because our condition is, if it is more than 1, that is more than 0, that is 1. Positive value, 1. Negative value, minus 1. And 0, that becomes 0. So I have three different values I have taken for sign, right? So this is positive, that's why positive. This is negative, that's why negative. This is 0, this is 0. I think this is clear. Come to square root, insert SQRT, without it returns the square root of a number. Simple. That is in your assignments, you have discussions also. So you can practice. So now, this is things you'll have. Now you have a square root of this. I have taken complete square root, complete value, you will have 8. Another one is which cannot be divided, you will have a fractional value. So that is 48. So I have shown you. This way you can get. Now, see here, I can show you one interesting part. I can put one function here. What is that functions? You can put like this also, multiple functions. Now, I have a round, R-O-U-N-D, round functions. Round functions takes the value first. It must be rounded with which position? Suppose I want to make it 0. 0 positions. Just see the result. What would be? See here, 7 is coming. Right or not? So that time, see previously it was looking very odd. It is a very fractional value is more than 15 times. It is repeating, right? So now it is complete. If you want to keep 1, you can see here. Only one digit you will have. If you want to 2 here, so you can put here, see, 9-3. And if you don't want, you remove this. Simply. Only square root, what about the square root of this? So you look at. So this is how multiple functions can be used. We call it nested functions. Within functions, we can use. Right? This is how, this is, these are the functions you have. Next, you will have a truncate. This is very important. Normally, we use in some different situations, we use this truncate. So sometimes we use round also, sometimes we use truncate functions. So truncate functions returns a number to specified number decimal places. You have to truncate it, just truncate it. So now copy this. I'll show you the output of this. And if you have doubt, you can ask me. Now, this is the same syntax that we have from dual. Select truncate. That's the same value I have taken previously. That's the same 0 and 1 and minus 1 position value I am taking. See here. These are the 445. Exactly it is coming. It will be removed. There should not be any formula here rounding all these things. No. Just it, you truncate it. That means you, remove that. So till decimal, you remove all. So decimal part will be removed, 0. So 345 exactly. There is no rounding concept here. Truncate means suppose one digit we have to take. That means after digit. So we should not check whether it is 5, 6, 10, whatever may be. So just remove all this. So it must be removed, this both 5 and 6. Only one digit will be there after decimal. So minus, that means here we have to remove here. See here, when you are, that's the difference, exceptions. When you are truncate, the integer part with providing the minus positions value, so that time you have to be very careful. So here something else you are getting. It is not 34. If you have a 34, the complete three digit data can be invalid data. So it is already given three digit data, but if you remove five, it will becomes a two digit data. So what happens, we will preserve this. That means we are removing five till zero. Now put here, that is one digit we have removed. Nothing will be happen to second digit, but first digit, it comes to zero part. Now if I'll put here minus two, that's very interesting. You put here, actually you have to do, because only I have to give one example. You have to see every consequences, every different types of alternatives you can put, and you can check it. Okay, now why I'm giving two, you can see, remember, this was for minus one, this is 340. If I'm going for minus two, what will happen? 300, right? So it is nothing, the concept of rounding here. Here what happens, we are discarding, but position must be there. Three digit number must be there, right or not? If you are giving here zero, if you'll tell, sir, we are removing here, nothing will happen. So after right hand side, zero is no use of this. Unless after decimal part, if you'll see. If I'll write 0.1 and if I'll write 0.10, nothing will happen in calculation expression. But when we are going for 0.1 and 0.01, that matters. So similarly, when we are rounding or truncating, so this must be there. Now, if I'll put minus three, can you suggest me what would be the output of this? Anyone? I think this is there. Can you expect what would be the output of this last part? I have given minus three. Yes, obviously it will be zero. Check it. It will be zero. Zero, 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 that means zero. Three places will be zero. So it will be zero. I think this is clear. So now we'll move to next query. So these are the query you have to see. This is very simple, greatest number. You can get find out the greatest number among all. So that is very simple. List number. So which one is the smallest number, you can find out similar way. Now we can go for, this is very important, aggregation functions. Normally we use aggregation functions in our database in every point of view, right? What is aggregation functions? It aggregates different values, different set of values, and it gives you a single value, aggregation function. By combining all, that's why we call it aggregation function. What are the different kinds of functions we have? Average, mean, then mode, mean value, max value. Then you can see here, these are the count star. Then you have max. Then you will have sum. So these are the functions under your aggregation functions. Very important, very important. So now exam point of view or in database point of view, these are the functions we use normally. See here, what is the syntax over here? Select average, then you have to put the column name from the table name with conditions, right? I'll put one query here. See here, we have one table, salesman, right? So I can put here. Already I have created. Now, what happens here? Average of what? Average of sales amount. How much sales he has done? And sales table, each and every columns or each and every values, records, it will be combined, average value will come. See here, I'll show you first the detail of this. So what I can write? Star. See here, these are the values you have. Now one column is there, that is your sales amount. And we have to find out the average of this. All values must be taken. So now I can put here the functions, AVG, aggregation functions. Within bracket, I can put here what that column I can take. SALSAMT. You must write the correct spelling of this column. Now I am averaging these values. Just see here. This is 3140. 3140. Got my point? This is average value. Average value. Right? So now If you want to put a simple query, average of this. Now see here, average can be used. I can move back. I can use here sum. That is sum of all values will display. That is also aggregate values. I can use minimum MIN. So that is also, you can have minimum 3000 is there. Maximum, we have a 3500. I think I have seen that. So maximum 3500, right? So this way you can use. Now next is very important, count. So count functions we use, number of records we have to count. Now count functions used for counting the number of records. So if I'll put here star, so it takes all records. So all records. Now see how many records will come, we'll see. See, five records are there. Is it actually five records? Just check it. Select star from EMP. Select star from Sales Master. So five will be there. See here, five records are there. So it counts. Sometimes what happened? In this particular instance, we don't have everywhere you will have values. But if you don't have values, right? If you don't have any values, sometimes what happens? So it gives you other values. Now, if I'll show you which kind of things I can show you. Now I have to move to the insert statement, right? Here I can show you it's getting running. So now I can use here one. I have one query I have. I'll show you. I can move to insert statement, right? So insert statement, I think here. I have another file we have. 16. This is a DCL statement. I think this is create. I think here it will be there. Okay. I want to take one query. Okay. I have to put that. I have to use that how it can be used. Right. Master table. That is yes. We can go for insert trigger. No, this is not. This is trigger. We have so many things to complete this. Right. So now, this is about to insert a table. Now, another file I have. So I can show you in this particular syntax, I can show you. Directly I can show you, but it takes time. That's why I'm taking one query from here. So I can move to this. Now, suppose I want to insert values here, right? So I can insert here. So DML statement, right? Insert into, this is the syntax, into, that is our table name is, what's the table name? Salesman. This is the table name. And we have to insert salesman underscore number, comma, name. You can see the you can see the column name. As per that, you have to write salesman name. It must be exactly match. Okay. Then I can put sales amount. Sales amount I must put, comma. Then target, excuse me, target, T-A-R-G-E-T. Now these things I want to put, right? Values, V-A-L-U-E-S, values. And I have to enter the values. So I can put S, excuse me. S-0-0-0, this format I can put. 4 times 0, suppose 6, excuse me, then single quotation mark complete, then you will have a name. Suppose I am writing, you can write your name here, so you can see here, then I can put salesman's name, amount, suppose 10,000, I have put 10,000, numeric value, you need not require the single quotation mark. So now that target is your, suppose 15,000. I'm giving, right? This way I can enter this value, right? So how many columns we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I'm inserting this value. Now what happens? I'm telling this value will be null because I'm not entering these values. So I want to suppress this, right? Now I can show you. Run this. Now system master dot address. Insert null into system salesman master. Somewhere it is insert null. Okay. So it is not accepting null values. I think not null is there constraints. Somewhere constraints is there. So how to see? Remember this query, I am going to go for different query. That I have to show. DESC sales. Salesman underscore master. Okay, no problem. Capital letter will be possible. So we can see what's the conditions we have. Yes, see here. Remarks is there, nullable. And state is nullable. City is nullable. But these are the columns is not allowed nullable. Nullable means you can accept null values or you cannot accept null values. This way we can have. So you have to definitely, you have to put some values here. So nullable means it can accept null values. If I'll skip this, now I can put here what happens here. You can see object. Now it will be our, if we have given salesman number, salesman name, I think time is there. Okay, we have 2-3 minutes. I'll finish up this. So name, then address can be there. So I have to add here address, right? So what is the spelling? A-D-D-R-E-S-S, address. I can put any uppercase, lowercase, there is no problem, but it must be corrected. So city and state, I'm skipping. Then I can put sales amount target and year sales, right? That must be there. So I can put after target, I can put here, YTDSALES or something else. Okay, I have written both. You can see, you can type any format, right? So now sales. So here I can add after address. I can put here. I don't know where which place you are belongs to. I can put here Pune, right? I don't know Diksha which place is she is belongs to. So now I'm giving 10,000, 15,000, and one value I can put 50. Now we can execute this. Now here, the larger specified precision not allowed. Somewhere you can find out the precision's problem. That means I think this one, 0.5 we can take. No. Somewhere, where is that place? We can see. Now, if you have doubt, control X, that is I have in the memory. Now, select star from, your salesman underscore MSTR. So, you can run it. So, here, 50 50 50, this is okay. Target 100 400, these are the value, and remarks is there. I think remarks is there or not null or null. I think there is a mistake. DESC. Okay, I can put here because time is running now. DESC, just execute it. I think remarks must be there. So that was the problem. We have to give here remarks. Remarks. Then remarks here. I can put here value 50. Okay. Remarks, single quotation mark. I can give. Very good. V-E-R-Y. G-O-D. I think I can put here single quotation. Now you can run it. Again, there is a problem. Precisions allowed. Okay, I think is it good. So you have to check each and every part. Cells, I think somewhere. There should not be any problem. Sorry. I think this is time. Next time you can have because. Otherwise, what happens? I'll do 1 second. I can take this is insert query I have. Okay. Salesman underscore. You can add here. DASC. We have to check here. What's the problem? Primary key and what number is yields target sales work at 260. It must be. There should not be any problem. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Number salesman. Salesman underscore number, salesman name, address, okay, address, and yes, inserted. This value is fixed. Most probably, that's the problem. One row is created. So now you can see here. I think I'm running late. I'll stop this. Start from salesman master. You can see here null value will be there. So now if you are making count, select count, count, count within bracket. If you are giving state, so how many state will come? One less than six. That means five will come. State. This is okay. Run it. Sorry, from keyword I have select count from see here 5 is coming. That's actually I wanted to show you. So now we can end this particular session. You might have enjoyed this. You go for all the queries to use whatever the select queries we have. Next time we will have a DML, DDL, and TCL, and so on, DCL statement. Okay? Thank you, students.
Sure.
I'll just minimize this.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. So,